Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ansar Ahmad, and in this lecture I'm going to talk about signaling system 7. The previous lectures we gone through what is signaling system and what is the function of signaling system. In this lectures I would like to talk about a specific type of signaling system which is named as signaling system 7. The consultative committee on international telegraphy and telephony based in Geneva recommended seven formats related to signaling. So as we can see that initially CCITT gave seven formats related to signaling. The first five, that is 1 to 5 formats related to in-band signalings, which we already discussed in the previous lecture. So if you did not watch the previous lectures, then please please try to know about that lectures because it is important what is in-band signaling and what is out-band signaling. Okay, so the first five formats related to in-band signaling, and the last two, that is from 2 to 7, belongs to common channel signaling or out-band signaling. In in-band signaling, voice information and signaling information travel on common path. So already we know about that one, that is in-band signaling. In in-band signaling, voice information and signaling information travel on common paths, wherein common channel or outbound signaling, voice information and signaling information travel on different or separate path. The concept of CCS has been extended by ITU-T. That is International Telecommunication Union for telecommunication. Okay, in mid-1960s to improve the network capability. So, CCS has been extended by ITU-T. Okay. So SS7 is a set of telephony signaling protocols which are used to set up most of the world's public switch telephone network. So signaling system is very much useful to set up the PSTN or public switch telephone network throughout the world. The main purpose is to set up and tear down the telephone calls. The main functions or the purpose of SS7 signaling is to set up, to maintain, and to tear down the calls. Other uses included number translations, prepaid billing mechanism, SMS, and variety of other mass market services. Other than this one, that is, it provides only set up and tear down, but it is not like that. It has other important functions are also, like number translation, prepaid billing mechanism, SMS, and a variety of other mass market services. SS7 is suitable for any transmission medium. These are the features. Okay, we are talking about the features of SS7. SS7 is suitable for any transmission medium that is can be operated over both the terrestrial and satellite links. So it is suitable for terrestrial and satellite links. Okay, that is which are connected by satellites or which are connected by the microwave link. As we have used these terms in satellite communications and cellular system. SS7 is optimized to work with the digital SPC exchange utilizing 64 kbps digital channel. It is also suitable for operation over analog channels. So SS7 is optimized to work with digital SPC, store program control. Okay, what was that? That is the switching system, electronic switching system, utilizing which uses 64 kbps digital channel. It is not useful for the digital signal, but it is also suitable for operation over long analog or analog channels. SS7 is suitable for various communication services such as telephony, text, data, images, video, and as well as cellular system. It is also used in cellular system. Okay, so you can check the architecture of cellular system where we use it. Okay, high performance and flexibility along with the future-oriented concept which meets new requirements. Okay, it provides high performance and flexibility for the new requirements. High reliability for message transfer. Processor friendly structure of all the messages because signal units in multiple of 8 bits. So we for signal units is 8. What is signal units? I'll let you know in the next slides or the during this presentation itself. SS7 networks are much faster, efficient in the call setup and teardown. So they are much faster as compared to other signaling system like 1 to 6. We have SS7s because somewhere SS6 was slower. Flexible structure which accommodate all the technical advancement in telecommunication system. And this is very important, and this is known as the SS7 network architecture. So just try to know what is the network architecture of SS7. You know, this is a PSTN, public switch telephone network, in which we have SSP. What is SSP? Let me explain in next slides. Okay, these SSPs are connected with STP and SCP. What are these? I will explain in the next slides. Okay, these SSP and STP and SCP are connected via some links. Okay, so this PSTN actually does not work itself. Somewhere SS system or signaling system become the backbone for the smooth functioning of PSTN network. Without SS7 signalings, it is just like handicapped. It can not set up the call, maintain the call, or even tear down the calls, because SS7 has a lot of features which we have discussed in previous lectures. So what are the links? That is, this is A link, C link, and you can see B, D link. What are these and how they work, and what are SSP, SSC, SSP, STP and SCP. Okay, so this part belongs to the PSTN, that is known as the exchange, and these are the SS7 signaling somewhere. The entire exchange work with the help of this signaling system. So let me explain various terms used in this network architecture. The SS7 network is built out of the essential component interconnected by the signaling link. So SS7 network is built up of combining many signaling links or interconnected links. The network is made up of several links like A, B, C, D, E, and F. Of course, they have their own special functionality, and other than these links, we have special nodes which are known as SSP, STP, SCP. Each node is identified on the network by a number and a point code. So each node is identify a particular number and which is known as a point code. So first of all, SS components. What is SSP? This is the SSP, and this is the abbreviation, and this is the name, signaling switching points or service switching points. And the symbol of this SSP is this circle. Okay, then other one is STP, which is abbreviated as signal transfer point. Signal transfer point, and it is represented by this figure. So this is SSP, which is denoted by this circle, and this is or and this is like a square or a rectangle, which is diagonally connected. SCP, signal control points, and this is just like a drum, which is repeated by this one. Okay, now how they are connected in the network? This is the we can assume this is the these are the subscriber, calling subscriber or called a subscriber, which are directly connected to SSP. And what is SSP? What is the function SSP? I will explain in the next slides. Then SSP is connected with the STP via this link. This link may be ABCD. Of course, I will explain this also. And then STP is connected with SCP. What is SCP? I will also explain. And further, you can see that this is also a subscriber or user, which is connected with the same thing. So these are the SS links. All these are the SS links. This one, that one, and these are the trunks. Trunks are wires which connect connects to telephone exchange. Okay, so somewhere you can see that is if this is calling subscriber and this is the call subscriber. So calling subscriber in this exchange and call subscriber is other exchange. So what is SSP in telephone? A SSP or service switching point is the telephone exchange. So SSP is just like the exchange, telephone exchange, that initially respond when a telephone caller's dial a number by sending a query to a central database called a service control point so that the call can be handled. So SSP is you can understand just like the exchange by which user or anybody get connected by sending a query to a central database, okay, which is known as the SCP. SSP can terminate and originate SS7 message but can't transfer. So it can just terminate or originate the message but cannot be transferred. SSP are switches that have SS7 software and terminating signaling links. So these are the SS7 software. SSP is the SS7 software and some terminating signaling links. Service control points, the other components. SCP is usually a computer as a front end to a database. So this SCP may be known as the database system, front end to a database system, which is used by the exchange or SSP. SCP is an interface between telecom database and the SS7 network. So this is the interface between telecom database and the SS7 network. Usually SSP send a query to the database. Whatever a user wants, that query is sent by the SSP to the SCP. Okay, and NSP give back that data to the SCP. So what are the possible database accessible via SCP? That is home location register, which is used in, of course these terms are used in cellular system, LNP, local number portability, allows people to change service provider but keep their same telephone number. OSS operation support system associated with the remote maintenance center for monitoring and managing SS7 network. VLR, visitor location registers. So these all are database registers, and SCP is just like the database unit which is used by SSP. Signaling system, signaling transfer point, STP. STP is responsible for transferring SS7 message between the other SSC nodes, like a router does packet transfer in data network. So STP is just like the transfer unit. Yes, it indicates signaling transfer point. So it transfers the signaling messages. This routing is done based on routing information in MTP3, routing label of SS7 message. Hence, STP is not the source or the destination of any message. because this is the just the transferring point, so it cannot be the source and destination. Okay, route each incoming message to an outgoing sending based on routing information obtained in the SS7. So whatever route information it gets, it just transfer that SS7 message to that destination. NSTP's main function is to identify the best for two SCPs to communicate. So other than transferring the point, it also provides the best path for two SCPs to communicate. STP are pair to ensure redundancy. So in case if any one route is not working, so it has other options or alternative routes. There are three level of STP: national signal transfer point, international signal transfer point, and gateway signal transfer point. So for proper transferring the message, SS7 message, it has three points, that is three STP points, which is known as the international, gateway, national. Okay, so if it may be national, if this is not national, then via gateway it goes to the international, where all SSP STP are connected. SS7 links. Now what are the SS, the link between nodes are full duplex, that is 56.64.153.6 or 1984 kilobytes. So the links which we have seen in the architecture of SS7, that is 56.64.153.6, and one or more signaling link can be connected to the same two endpoints that together form a signaling link set. Signaling links are added to link set to increase the signaling capacity of the set. Okay, so they connect the various nodes of the exchange. Okay, these are the signaling link which you can see. This SP is connected via this one. These are connected with C. This is connected to E. These are the F. So it is a point to remember that by which link SP or STP or SSP are connected. This is the only point to remember. So observing these all nodes, you can see where A is working, where C is working, and where B is working, and where C, D, and E working. So these are the explanation of SS7 links. A link access provide access to the network connecting signaling endpoint SCP or SSP to STP. So link A works between the connecting signaling endpoint SCP. So it connect SCP or SSP to STP. So this is just an interconnection. B link, which work as the bridge, connect an STP to another STP. Okay, then C link connect STP performing identical function. So whenever identical functions are working, then C link connected to that one. T link diagonal connect a secondary STP pair to a primary STP pair and a quad link. So by just observing the this figure, you can find out where A and B is working, whether this is straight or this is directly connected, or this is the diagonal cross or diagonal connected. So guys, all about the E link and F link also, which are E link are connected to SSP to an alternate STP. F link is used to SSP and SCP. So there is nothing to explain in this SS7 link. Just you can observe the architecture, and by just identifying the SCP and STP and SCP, you can just see that is how they are connected with the help of these links. But the question arises, what goes over signaling link? Signaling information is passed over the signaling link in form of a message which is called signaling unit. So what goes on the signaling link? That is simple signaling link inform that is signaling information is passed over the signaling link. So whatever information we send on the network, that is or signaling information that is carried by the signaling link. Okay, so guys, it was all about the architecture of SS7. Hope you got it, and if you are not getting anything, please let me know. And if you want to give any suggestion, then this is also equally welcome. I hope you are getting it properly. Okay, so guys, we'll meet in next lecture. Till then, have a great time. Take care.